gang problem in Los Angeles is a historical one. It was the birthplace of many of the gangs that are currently spreading across the United States, whether they be the Latino gangs, 18th Street, MS-13, or the black gangs, the Crips and the Bloods. They all had their birthplace in the city of Los Angeles in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. And what we are dealing with today is a continuation of that multi-generational phenomenon.
And when I look at this from the perspective of 43 years in the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department, I've seen what was once a benign problem become one of the most vexing and threatening realities of Los Angeles County. And it's all happened on my watch, as they say.
It's kind of like a personal journey for me because I started in the old hardcore suppression model and benefited from it. I loved being a gang officer, you know, and I've seen this from every phase. And now I'm seeing it from a completely different aspect, and I see it working.
For me, as a civil rights lawyer, what civil rights do you have if you don't have safety? Safety is the first civil right. So all of our lawsuits and all of the victories that we had were not keeping these communities safe.
Well, who's better prepared to do this than those that wear the uniform and are supposed to keep the community safe? And the question is, how do you do this better? And I'm willing to stick my neck out as an elected official and say that we need to do things better. We need to respect the fact that our capacity to lead is stronger. Deputies need to be community leaders and community organizers in order for us to deal with this gang problem effectively. We will not arrest our way out of the gang problem, but we're not also going to police our way out of the gang problem.
And as one cop, a gang cop in LA said, Sergeant Pierce said, you know, Connie, these kids don't stand a chance. And that's what I hate about my job, is that, you know, I want to be able, as a cop, to be able to give these kids some hope. And instead, I'm just here to arrest them. And I want to help you change that.
How do you get a department that's really good at arresting people to take on the rest of the strategy?
The LAPD was an arrest machine. They described themselves as a hook 'em and book 'em. The satisfaction of the individual officer, the measurement of success of the organization, was in its arrest statistics. And they did a hell of a job. Every year, lock 'em up, and every year, crime went up. And every year, racial antagonism went up. Two of the worst race riots in the history of America were, in many respects, a direct result of that mentality. As part of a focus group study that's being undertaken in my department, interviews are being done of all my captains. And I have a captain, Captain Bob Green. He could be the poster boy for the Los Angeles Police Department of the old and the new. He is the white captain of the 77th area. 154 murders in 1989 when he was working there as a young sergeant. He's now the captain. So far this year, I think he's had, Charlie, 3 murders so far this year? Less than 10 in a command that used to generate over 150 a year. He, in response to a question from the interviewer about the how the culture and the philosophy of the department was changing, talked about, well, the attitude, the philosophy of the department used to be hook 'em and book 'em. And he says, that's no longer what we're into. He says, the future is not in handcuffs. Just think of that comment from a captain of police in the Los Angeles Police Department working in what was at one time the most dangerous area of that city. The future is not in handcuffs.
Some of the folks that are watching this may not have multi-generational gangs now, but you will. When we do gang search warrants, we take Department of Children and Family Services with us with the express purpose of pulling the kids out of the home that are doomed to relive this and getting them placed and putting them into adoption or to foster homes. Because the reality is that if they continue down the path of their grandparents, this is a death sentence.
In LA, we have spent $25 billion with a B in the last 30 years on a war on gangs. We now have 6 times as many gangs and twice as many gang members. We're reducing crime, but we're not blocking the transmission of the mindset. The culture has metastasized. And it's now taking over youth culture. Look at our kids. Listen to their music. Look at how they dress. We've allowed gang culture to infect youth culture. And if we don't stop it, it'll become the culture. We've been handing out fly swatters for a malaria epidemic. You have to drain the swamp, get rid of all standing water. You have to train the population to put on the insecticide. You have to hand out the nets and train the parents to make sure the kids are sleeping under the nets. You have to do a lot of things. You have to change the conditions in that ecosystem that spawn the disease. That's what this model is. And Sheriff Baca and Chief Bratton have said, we want that. That's how we got together.